there's a balance. As a musician, I want my kids to have a great deal of musicianship. I want them to be good readers. I want them to understand theory. I want them to be exposed to a wide variety of music. But I also want them to become great people. I want them to be compassionate. I want them to realize what hard work is. I'm a big proponent, and again, this is a bit of a change for me over even the past few years, because we never stop learning as choral music educators, is that if you've got a great poem, make sure that you spend time on the poem before you ever pass out a piece of music, so the kids understand what they're singing about. I think so many times we jump into the music, get those notes, hear those chords, hear those lines. We really ought to be talking about the lyric first, even to the point of let's underline the important lyrics so that when we're singing those, we emphasize those just a little bit more. I read a lot, and there was a book that said, make every day an event. Make every rehearsal an event. Give the kids something they weren't expecting. It can be singing in a circle on that day. And I did that my last year of teaching at the community college. This is about 3 years ago, and I had a vocal jazz ensemble. Actually, I had two vocal jazz ensembles since I was only given 2 hours twice a week. I opened it up to everyone who wanted to sing. I ended up with 35 kids who wanted to sing. So for 90 minutes, all 35 sang. And then the last half an hour, I took the top eight. And I said, and we'll do our little close mic'd small group thing. It was the wisest decision I ever made. We're educators. We should be inclusive. And I tried to make every rehearsal an event. And you know what? Just having that attitude, I think changed the weather. It was suddenly, they sensed that. And when it comes to concerts, you know, again, we work up to concerts, but I always say, the concert's just a celebration. Oftentimes, teachers tell me, I have trouble getting kids to my concerts. And I know there are multiple reasons. Sometimes it's poverty, kids who can't get there. Sometimes it's just, I don't really like this. But if you've done your job along the way, this is the celebration. There should be no stress, no fear. Let's get up and show them what we can do.